Summer Kids, it's Miss Kiana. Guess what we're gonna be talking about this week? I'll give you a little hint. Come with me. Okay. So, this week, we're going to talk about Jesus washing the disciples' feet. Yeah, you heard me right. Jesus washes his friends' feet. Would you wash your friend's feet? I mean, I would have to love my friend a lot for me to wash their feet. Because, let's be honest, sometimes we walk on dirt, right? And our feet can get really dirty or really muddy. But Jesus decided that he wanted to wash the disciples' feet anyway. So as I'm walking through the wilderness and I'm getting my feet super dirty and I'm getting leaves and dirt on them, Jesus would still wash my feet. Isn't that amazing? Even though sometimes we feel like Jesus might be far away, he's still going to wash my feet. He's still going to serve me because he loves me. So that's what we need to learn, is that even though we might not be happy with our neighbors or our parents, we still need to serve them because we love them. Jesus loves us, he serves us, so we should serve others. All right, kids, I hope you guys learned something good today. Be safe, behave, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!
Hey, friends, how are you today? Shout it out! I think I've got to be the best at making slime ever. Do you like playing with slime? I can make slime out of anything. Toilet paper, paper, anything. Even sand. Speaking of sand, I wonder where my friend Dan is today. Hey Dan, what are you up to?
Hey Callie, I found the most interesting creature. I'm so fascinated.
What did you find?
Callie, I found a turtle. A turtle doesn't care how fast the world is moving around it. It'll move whenever it wants to.
So it can't go fast?
Not at all. Have you ever felt the need to want to go faster or get somewhere faster, but you still have to move slowly?
Oh, yes. Whenever it's time for school to end, it feels like it's taking longer than usual.
Exactly. That reminds me of the Bible story of Joseph.
It's time for our Bible story. A long time ago, there was a man named Joseph. Joseph was a part of a very large family. So large that he had 11 brothers.
11? That's a lot of brothers.
Yes, 11 brothers. Out of all the sons that his father had, Joseph was by far the favorite. And his father gave him a beautiful coat with lots of colors. The brothers were not happy about that. They became pretty upset and became jealous of Joseph.
Oh no!
Things became worse for Joseph during this time because he would get special dreams telling the future. For example, he dreamt about 11 stalks of grain bowing to him. And then he also dreamt about the sun, moon, and 11 stars bowing to him as well.
What did that mean?
Most likely, it was a dream that reminded him of the brothers in his family. 11 stalks of grain, 11 stars. I'm sure Joseph thought of his 11 brothers when he woke up. The dream suggested that Joseph would become someone very important. Maybe even more influential than all of his brothers.
I hope he didn't tell his brothers his dream.
I know, right? But he did tell them, and it made things worse. The brothers ignored all of the dreams and great things that Joseph told them would happen and came up with a plan to make him go away.
How did they do that?
They put Joseph in a hole in the ground, and when some traveling merchants came by, they gave Joseph to them to take far away.
Merchants?
Merchants are people who sell and buy things. These merchants were on their way to Egypt, and now Joseph was too.
That's very sad.
It was, but Joseph knew the dreams he was getting came from God. Wonderful dreams that God would make happen one day. He knew he had to wait and trust God, even though he was far away from home now.
Isn't that so interesting, though, friends? Joseph knew that God promised great things, but it probably felt like they were never going to happen when he got into that bit of trouble with his brothers. But you know what? We're going to find out next time that Joseph's story is nowhere near done. I know that God will keep those promises in the end. Maybe now I can work on being more patient in school when the day is ending. Or not. Catch you next time, friends. Bye. Callie out.